Now I'm shaking, drinking all this coffee. These last few weeks have been exhausting. I'm lost in my imagination.
Good PM today. It's 3:04 PM and welcome to Darwin Workshop. And nice to see you, nice to see me. How are you? If you ask me, I'm fine, thank you. Shout out for all who got birthday today of September, the month of September. And much more to come for your birthday. And what I'm doing right now is practicing to make a pin safety pin. Okay, my first practice, troubleshooter. Okay, short wire. This is 10 gauge, no, I'm sorry. I mean 10 inches only and 20 gauge. Big troubleshooters, big beads. And that's what happened, okay? All you're gonna do is practice anyway, and the way you find what's wrong. And this one here, it's kind of perfect, 7 beads, okay? And look like a safety pin to me, right there. See, look like safety pin. All right, and this is my final practice, 12 inches long, still. No, I think it's 12 gauge or 15 gauge, kind of thick, but it look like safety pin. Okay, it's 12 inches long, 6 millimeter of a bead, but it's 7. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 of the spacer. And I like it. So practice is getting you better. Okay, now What I'm going to do is going to make a safety fence. You can put it like that. See? That's a safety fence. Oops. Okay. Safety fence, LOL. And while I'm making a safety fence, you can make it, you can use this as your hair fence also. See? Okay? It's too soft. So I'm gonna try. Yeah, this is 12 gauge. Okay? Soft. Thick, but it's soft. Okay, and now, as I'm saying, I'm going to try a impossible, Mission Impossible again. This is 15 gauge hard, and this is about 12 gauge again. See what happened, okay? Oh, excuse me. Up to... course, soften up for this one. I mean, not soft, it's sharp. It's not as sharp, but it's smoothing. Okay, it's not smoothing to drink, LOL. That's a smoothie. And just trim the edges. And then just file this one, file around. Okay, this is good. All right, see what we're gonna get from this one here. It's another style. You can make, you can use the safety pin or a hairpin, okay? So this is 12 gauge. And we are going to take 3 inches and bend it, okay? See the bending? Have to use my finger to avoid to use the tool, because this kind of wire is coated by the color. See, because as soon you use the tools, metal tool is going to scratch the color. Very delicate, see? But you can use this kind of tool, it won't hurt that. And you just squeeze it a little bit there, okay, like that. Look like this, okay. If you can squeeze more, a little, it's slippery. So you use this kind of tool, it won't scratch your coated wire. Okay, see, you can straighten up this like this too. See? There you go. And then from there, we grab the shortest wire and we take about 2 inches, okay, from 2 inches right there, you hold it, from 2 inches you hold that, like that, and you start wrapping. This is soft, so you can start rubbing three times if you can. You can adjust it after you rub three times. You can adjust it after rubbing. I know it's gonna be look like separated like this. That's two and three. Okay. And three. So it's all twisted, but you can adjust it like that. Okay, it's gonna be look like that. Like this, like that, LOL. So, one more wrap. Hold that there. And there's three. Okay. Yeah, it's just a matter of adjusting, okay? And you can squeeze this a little bit, so I'm gonna use this metal tool. I hope it's not gonna scratch too much. There you go. Okay. I'm just gonna cut that, trim it, extra wire. And go ahead and tuck it in. Gonna be look like this. Lot of adjusting. Like this. See. Okay, now we are going to use, see what I can use for that. This kind of tool. We're gonna put that in the middle, okay? In the middle of this. And we go to number 8. Ooh, I don't wanna scratch that. So we go in the middle. Okay. And we bend it this way. Gonna be look like this. See, I don't want to scratch that. That's why I'm using this tool like that. And then after that, you can bend in the edge. Just a little dent. I hope that we don't. Scratching. Then gonna be look like this. Okay. Now we are going to, let's see here. We are going to bend that a little bit, or maybe later after we put the insert the beads, okay? So we can insert the spacer. I hope the spacer fit. Hey, how do you know that's a spacer? And then we make a different style for this, okay? Beads, kind of oblong bead. And then we put another spacer here. Let me see. Come on, fit. It's kind of a big hole. We're gonna find a bigger spacer. Not too big, but just enough to insert that. There we go. There's two, and we are going to put a small bead, 6 millimeter. You have to put, you go to the end of the wire, that way you can find a hole. Then we get the spacer again. There we go. It's gonna be look like this. There we go. We gotta put the big one. And another spacer. Between the big beads and the 6 millimeter on that. Come on, get in there. Don't be shy. Just keep on turning around the beads till we get there. See, it's scratching the wire. See, look like this. And then if you're satisfied, it can be stopped right there, or if you want, you know. Or if you want a bigger one, longer one, it's up to you. But see, it's like this. Like that. Hmm. I think this is enough. You know, not too long, but you can bend this. You need a one spacer. Like this. Okay. Something is itching me. Okay, this is enough, I believe. And then we're just gonna make a loop, look like a safety fence in the edge. See? To make a loop, I'll make sure we don't scratch the wire, but I cannot promise. And we are going to a bigger loop about that size. They're almost on the end of the of this round nose. Okay, you pull it like this, okay, you switch, and you pull it like this again, like that, and then from there, you have to switch that and pull another loop. Okay. And then you stop right there. And try to even that up to get that end to look like a safety fence. See? And then you have to bend this a little bit. To reach the end. So what I did is, I guess it's small. I need about 15 of these inches long. Okay. So, but this is gonna look like I need 15 gauges, 15 inches long. Okay, so I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. See the difference? This is 15 inches long. Okay, 15 gauges. There you go. So you can make it. It's better and longer. Okay, if I cut that, I'll make sure I cut longer, even up with this over here. Let me see what happened. If you don't find out, you're never going to know. Okay, there you go. See, you got plenty of room. And you can straighten this up. Okay. And cut more, maybe in the middle of that one there. That dent over there, you can cut that from there. Not too short. There you go. See that? And then all you're gonna do is file it up straight and rounded. Okay. And then you squeeze it like that. Okay. If you think it's still long, let's see if we bend this. See what happens. Bend this like that. Okay. And then we insert it. It's fit though, but it's just fat. LOL. We have to round it a little bit more. There you go. How's that? How's that apple? You can squeeze it a little farther if you want. Okay, but that's the style. Okay, 15 inches long. You can squeeze that, make it fatter, you know, inside of that. Squeeze that. Just loosen up a little bit and see how it look like. So you're just going to adjust it. Just like that. This one is kind of stubborn. They don't want to cooperate. There you go. It's just a matter of adjusting. There you go. Look like a safety pins now. Now you go like this, or you put in your hair. Just insert this into your head. You bun the hair first, and then you insert this one here in your hair. The bun hair, okay? And this one here, you can apply a bangle, just like this. See? You put some bangle in there. We can do that. All you're gonna get is a bunch of charm, okay? There's the charm over here. You can put that, where you wanna put a cat. See, there's a cat. All you're gonna do is put the jump ring. Okay, jump ring. This one is broken. I need new one. Insert the cat. Insert it over here. And safety, close that. See, while you're putting in your hair, the bun hair, okay? You can put in a bun hair. About this deep in your bun hair. Okay, or you remove that and you put this in your bun hair. Okay, so you got a lot of things to figure that out. And then you have this bangle, see? Safety pins with beads and charms. On one project. Okay, you can put one more if you want, or a beach hanging, you know, it's up to you. I'm just showing you that this is a safety pin decorated in your, you know, your shirt or blouse or coat, and then you insert that from here, you insert that to the bun hair, okay, and you got this decoration. Okay, thank you for watching, and you have a blessed day. You can do anything for this too. You can put this in a in your purse too also. So you got a charms for purse and to your hair pin and to the safety pin decoration. Okay? So you can do a lot of things. All right? Hang that in a purse. I don't have any more purse, but I got a zipper purse over here, and you can hook this. There you go. How do you like that? A safety pin to your coat or hair pins you can use, or you hang that as a charms in the purse. See? Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy it. And keep on trucking. Bye-bye for now. Woo! I said, see you later. Woo! LOL. Bye. Have a blessed Thursday.